Assalamu alaikum dear friends, this is Sajid Ali. Today's topic, Indian National Congress. It was a political party of India at the time of British. It was formed in 1885 by Allen Octavian Hume. He was a civil servant and British person, English person. So, dear friends, civil servant. He was civil servant at Bengal. When he decided, to make a social platform where Indians could discuss their problems, their issues, so he resigned from his post civil servant. So he thought to make a social platform for Indians. At first, the main objective of Indian National Congress was to discuss social issues. But Lord Dufferin suggested Allen Octavian Hume to change his idea from a social platform to a political platform. Lord Dufferin was a viceroy of British. He suggested him to a political platform. When Lord Dufferin said Allen Octavian Hume to make a political party instead of a social platform, because we had British had no any kind of opposition in the assembly, in the executive council, that's why Dufferin realized at that time that British should have a opposition of Indians to understand their psychology, their problems, and according to their psychology, their social issues, British government could solve their problems. That's why Lord Dufferin suggested Allen Octavian Hume to make a political platform for Indians. So, dear friends, in this way, Indian National Congress was formed by Allen Octavian Hume. He made a political party, not a social organization, social platform for Indians. Allen Octavian Hume was also the first secretary of Indian National Congress. The first session of Indian National Congress was conducted in 1885 December. At first, it was conducted in Pune. But then the place of session was changed from Pune to Bombay. So, dear friends, in this way, we briefly discuss about the Indian National Congress and its formation. What were the ideas of Muslims and their leaders? Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was the contemporary of Indian National Congress and its formation. Sir Syed was not in favor of Indian National Congress. That's why he told his followers to not join Congress. Because according to Syed Ahmad Khan, it would be a Hindu majority political party in future, and Muslims would be subordinate follower of Hindus, because Muslims are in subcontinent in India, not in majority. they were in minority as compared to Hindus. That's why at first Muslims should get education, should develop politically, socially, economically, and then compete Hindus politically and make a political party. That's why Sir Sayyid stopped all his followers, Muslims, to join Indian National Congress. That's why he was against Indian National Congress. These are Muslim presidents of Indian National Congress. When Congress formed, many British became the president of Indian National Congress. Hindus also became president of this political party, but Muslims were also the presidents of Congress in different times. Badruddin Tayyab ji, who was the first Muslim president of Congress in 1887. Rabbatullah Sani in 1896. Sayyid Muhammad Bahadur in 1913. Hassan Imam in 1918. Muhammad Ali Johar, Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar, became the president of Congress in 1923. Mukhtar Ahmad Ansari in 1927. Abul Kalam Azad in 1940 to 1946. So dear friends, in this way Muslims became the presidents of Indian National Congress, and we discussed in this lecture the formation of Indian National Congress and views of Muslims about this political party. So dear friends, thank you. Inshallah, we will discuss in my next lecture about the constitutional reforms. Take care. Allah Hafiz.